Now to an important follow-up on a 10 News investigation into the slave trade here in Australia. Reporter Matt Doran is in the Philippines, where 10,000 people marched through the streets of Manila today, demanding governments declare war on international traffickers. Now, Matt, exactly what is Australia's connection to this Filipino slave trade?
Well, Bill, we know that in Australia, federal police are on average uncovering a new human trafficking case every week. And the reality is that many of those victims are being sourced from impoverished villages and provinces here in the Philippines. In fact, in just the year to 2011, there were 9 Filipinos rescued from conditions of slavery across Australia, most of those as domestic workers or sex slaves. Now, when it comes to the abuse of trafficked minors in this country, Australians also have a pretty shameful record. So today, Filipinos took to the streets, 10,000 of them, in an extraordinary walk for freedom, and it was a deeply emotional show of strength.
Even to the transnational criminals responsible for the $30 billion a year slave trade, this is a fearsome army.
Stop human trafficking!
In the dark shadows of modern slavery, this woman is a saint. She's helped rescue more than 70,000 victims.
The human trafficker, beware. Be afraid. Hide now because we're coming to catch you.
In the slums of central Manila and in safe houses for victims, it's clear this is a problem Australia can no longer ignore. She was among 3 teenage girls trafficked into sex slavery at a brothel allegedly run and owned by an Australian.
And I'm used by 4 customers. When I asked my money, they only give me 1,000. But actually each man paid 800 pesos.
Walking through these impoverished slums on the outskirts of Manila, it is not difficult to see why trafficking is such a flourishing industry. In this area alone, perhaps a few square kilometres, there are 7,000 families living virtually on top of each other on the equivalent of less than $1 a day.
The cause is being emphatically supported by Australia's richest man. Mining magnate Andrew Forrest has launched a new global charity with the very bold aim of helping slaves walk free.
And we're going to go everywhere, we're going to go anywhere we can to find the problem and to do our best to stamp it out.
The lives of our most vulnerable are at stake.
Now, when you consider that there are an estimated 20 million slaves worldwide, Walk Free's task is a pretty enormous one, to say the very least. Now, they will start by setting up a so-called global fund, a central pot of money that brings together funding from various anti-trafficking agencies around the world. There will also be a huge social media campaign and rolling events like the march we saw here today in the Philippines that aim essentially to awaken the world's consciousness to the evil that is modern day trafficking.
Thank you, Matt Doran, with that report.